just to review, we have three regions, we have a bunch of stations that fit into that region, and we have information, attributes about these generation units. So this is the AF structure that we used to build this up for this particular example. And before I go any further, I want to just point out that I have a lot of different AF databases. You can have as many as you want. You don't have to have just one. And so in this case, the one I am going to use for this example is called Fleet Generation. So I focused in on one particular AF database, and this is what we're going to use in this example. You can see that the base level or the first level of the hierarchy are the regions, so central, north, southeast, which of course are the same as these guys here, central, north, southeast. And then within each district, the next level are the stations. And those are their names, probably the cities where they're located, I guess. And then the third level are the units. Okay, so there's a generation couple here. Each station may have three or four or five different generation units. Now, the other thing I want to mention, and I found this to be very important, and it's very important when you lay AF out to really work with templates. Even if you don't have attributes that you necessarily want to put with a particular level or an element, for instance, here I've got a district, you can see, or a region, let's say, and you can see I'm using a region template, and I don't have any attributes for that one yet. If I wanted to add an attribute in a month from now, at this level, all I would have to do is go add it to the template, and all my regions would automatically get that stuff. So it's always a good idea, even if you don't initially have anything to put as attributes around that element, to go ahead and make it a template, just because that gives you the ability to kind of add stuff to it later, and it saves you time. So it's just good practice to try to keep things templatized whenever you put them in your model as elements. I have a bunch of attributes, and let me see if I can zoom in on these. These are the attributes I have. And by the way, the other thing I think is a good thing to use are these categories. You can see the kind of groupings I have of these attributes. And that just makes it easier for, obviously, when you're looking at it, to kind of have all the pie tags in one group and so forth. There are four pie values involved here. And I have that listed under the category of hourly generation. So I have the gross generation and the net generation, and those are just readings coming in off the PI system. So those are kind of rates. So those are actually connecting to the DCS and bringing those values in. You'll notice below that I have a couple that are called total gross generation and total net generation. At least from my experience is that when you see us bringing back the data, we're going to bring back a record for every hour of operation. And so you're probably going to want a total value, a totalized value for that hour of operation to show how much power you actually generated for the whole hour, as opposed to a snapshot value that would be occurring at the end of that hour, which is just the rate at that particular point in time. And so what we've done here is used AF to basically calculate that total. And the way that's done is, if you were to look at the configuration of this attribute, is it's still a pi point data reference, but we filled out a little bit more of the dialog to request a total down here. So in the pi point data reference, you can put a tag name in there, make that an attribute, and you'll always get the snapshot value for that particular attribute. So that's one thing. And then what else we got? There's a couple other things down here. The other things are table lookups, table lookup data references based on the generation station. I figure out who the operator was. Remember, it's a three-letter acronym for the name of the company, and also what type of technology they use. I'm interested in those things. And then the bottom ones are calculations that I've made using the formula data reference. So if we were to look at those, I'm trying to remember what I did here. Okay, so in this one, first thing I do is I look up the capacity of the unit. This is a table lookup. So there's a table that has the unit name, it has who the operator was, what the technology was, and how many kilowatt hours it can generate. I'm just looking that stuff up here. And then the last one is a formula data reference where I'm just calculating some stuff. So basically, you can decide whether you want to do the calculation inside PowerPivot. So you could do this kind of calculation using DAX, as you'll see later. Or if it's something that you want to use in ProcessBook and DataLink, you can go ahead and put it in to AF.